Hello friends, welcome to 2thepoint. In this session, we are discussing about time and distance. Let's see the relation between distance, speed and time. Distance is equals to speed into time, which can also be written as speed is equals to distance by time, and time can be represented as distance by speed. To solve the problems on time and work or time and distance, you have to know the basic conversions. What are those conversions? Conversion from kilometer per hour to meter per second and meter per second to kilometer per hour. For example, think you have 18 kilometer per hour. This you have to convert into meter per second. To convert this kilometer per hour into meter per second, you have to multiply with 5 by 18, which is equals to 5 meter per second. And next, in order to convert meter per second into kilometer per hour, let's take 20 meter per second. 20 into, you have to reverse this 5 by 18 into 18 by 5, which is equals to 5 1s are 5 4s are 20. 18 4s are 72 meter per second. So from this example, we came to know that in order to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, you have to multiply it with 5 by 18. And in order to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour, you have to multiply it with 18 by 5. Let's solve your examples. A man crosses a 600 meter long bridge in 5 minutes. What is his speed in kilometer per hour? So we know that distance is equals to speed into time. Here distance is nothing but the length of the bridge. Distance is 600 meter and the time taken is 5 minutes. So this is in meter and this is in minute. We always have the formula for meter per second or kilometer per hour. Since this is in meter, convert this time into seconds. Multiply it with 60, you get 300 seconds. So now apply the formula. Speed is equals to distance by time, which is equals to 600 meter by 300 seconds. Now divide 600 by 300. Zeros get cancelled. 3 ones are, 3 twos are. That is nothing but 2 meter per second is the speed here. So they have asked us in kilometer per hour. So convert 2 meter per second into kilometer per hour. To convert this, 2 into 18 by 5, which is equals to 7.2 kilometer per hour. An aeroplane covers a certain distance at a speed of 240 kilometer per hour in 5 hours. To cover the same distance in 1 2 by 3 hours, at what speed it must travel? So it is given that the speed of the aeroplane is 240 kilometer per hour. And the time taken by it is 5 hours. And now we have to find the distance. Distance is equals to 240 kilometer per hour into 5 hours. Here hours get cancelled and we are left out with 240 into 5, which is equals to 1200 kilometer is the distance. And now we have to find at what speed the aeroplane must travel to cover 1200 kilometers in 1 2/3 hours. So it is nothing but we know the distance is 1200 kilometer and the time given is 1 2 by 3 hours, which can be written as 5 by 3 hours. And we know speed is equals to distance by time, which is equals to 1200 divided by 5 by 3. That is 1200 5 into 3. Divide this 5 1s are 5 2s are 10 5 4s are 20 240. You get speed is equals to 240 into 3, which is equals to 720 kilometer per hour. So now the aeroplane must travel at 720 kilometer per hour so that it can cover the distance in given time. If a person walks at 14 km per hour instead of 10 km per hour, he would have walked 20 km more. The actual distance traveled by him is. It is given that for 1 hour, a person walks 10 km. But on the particular day, he walks 14 km instead of 10 kilometers. Now let's take the distance as x, and we know that time is equals to distance by speed. And for while walking for 14 kilometers, he walks 20 kilometers more, that is d plus 20 by s. Here the distance is x by, and the speed is 10 kilometers per hour, which is equals to distance is x plus 20 and the speed is 14 kilometers per hour. Divide the denominators, 2 5s are 10, 2 7s are 14, and now cross multiply, you get 7x is equals to 5x plus 100. 7x minus 5x is nothing but 2x is equals to 100, and x is equals to 50. That means the distance traveled by the person is 50 kilometers. A man completes a journey in 10 hours. He travels first half of the journey at the rate of 21 kilometers per hour and second half at the rate of 24 kilometers per hour. Find the total journey in kilometers. So it is given that a man is traveling and he completes the journey in 10 hours. And it is given that in the total journey, first half of the journey he is traveling at the rate of 21 km per hour and second half of the journey at 24 km per hour. So now we have to find the total journey in kilometer. So let's take the total distance as x. So half of the distance means it becomes 1 by 2x and the other half as 1 by 2x. So we know here time taken is 10 hours. So this first half of the journey takes t1 of time and second half of the journey takes t2 hours of time. So that is nothing but t1 plus t2 is equals to 10 hours. And we know time is equals to distance by speed plus distance by speed. It is equals to 10 hours. Here distance we have taken as x, complete distance. But for the time t1, he is taking only 1 by 2x of distance. And the speed is 21 km per hour. And for the next part, he is taking 1 by 2x distance. And he is traveling at the speed of 24 km per hour. Now using this equation, solve for x. We get half into 24x plus 21x divided by 21 into 24, which is equals to 10. Take all the denominators on the other side, we get 45x is equals to 20 into 21 into 24. And now x is equals to 20 into 21 into 24 divided by 45, we get x is equals to 224 kilometer. Vishnu walks at the speed of 4 kilometer per hour and runs at the speed of 14 kilometer per hour. How much time does Vishnu take to cover the distance of 28 kilometer if he covers half of his journey by walk and other half by running? Here the distance is given as 28 kilometer and Vishnu walks at the speed of 4 kilometer per hour and he runs at the speed of 14 kilometer per hour. He covers half of his journey by walk. Here half of the journey by walk and half of the journey by running. For walk he takes 4 km per hour and for running he takes 14 km per hour. So here the distance is divided equally. So 28 km divided equally means we get it as 14 km and 14 km. For 14 kilometer he walks and for the other half of the 14 kilometer he runs. So here t1 plus t2, that is nothing but d by s plus d by s. First half of the distance is 14 kilometer and the speed is 4 kilometer per hour. And second half of the distance is 14 kilometer and the speed is 14 kilometer per hour. And now solve the equation, we get t is equals to 42 plus 14 by 12, which is equals to 56 by 12, and we get it as 14 by 3. Therefore time is equals to 4.66 hours. A man on tour travels first 160 km at 64 km per hour and the next 160 km at 80 km per hour. The average speed for the first 320 km of the tour is. Here it is given that a man is on tour and for the first 160 km he travels at 64 km per hour and for the next 160 km he travels at 80 km per hour. So if distance and speed is known, we can calculate the time. T1 plus T2, that is equals to distance by speed plus distance by speed. The first distance is 160 km and the speed is 64 km per hour. And the second distance is 160 km and the speed is 80 km per hour. If you divide this, you get 9/2, and this is the time. Now we have to find the average speed. Speed is nothing but distance by time. Distance is 320 and the time is 9/2 hours, which can be written as 320 into 2/9. If you divide this, you get 71.11 km per hour. A man takes 6 hours 30 minutes in walking to a certain place and riding back. He would have gained 2 hours 10 minutes by riding both ways. How long he would take to walk both the ways? The question is, a man walks to a certain place initially and while coming he rides. So totally it takes 6 hours 30 minutes time. If he is on ride on both the ways, then he would have gained 2 hours 10 minutes. Then out of 6 hours 30 minutes, he would have gained 2 hours 10 minutes. That is, the journey time would be 4 hours 20 minutes. And now for walking and riding, the time taken is 6 hours 30 minutes. That is nothing but 13/2 hours. And for riding both the ways, it took 4 hours 20 minutes. That is nothing but 13/3 hours. This can be written as 2TR is equals to 13/3. And here TR is equals to 13/6. Substitute the value of TR in the above equation, we get the value of TW, that is the time taken to walk. That is nothing but TW plus 13/6 is equals to 13/2. Therefore, TW is equals to 26/6 is the time taken to walk. Now we have to calculate the time if he is walking both the ways. We have calculated the time for half the way and now we have to calculate for returning also. So that is nothing but TW is equals to 26/6 into 2. This gives for both the journey time. That is nothing but TW is equals to 26/3 is the time taken by him to walk both the ways. That's all for this session. See you in next session. Thank you.